What's going on, CK crew? It's your boy CK2K, and welcome to another Knicks story. But before we jump into this, I need you guys to know that tonight, yes, tonight, we'll bring the very first episode of the new Coast to Coast show on this channel. For those who have not been paying attention, it is a live show that has myself and a good friend of mine, Brandon Moore, where we will be talking about the NBA every week on this channel. The first episode will be tonight, but the episodes will premiere every week on Sunday at 7 p.m. But I hope to see your faces tonight. We're going to be going over basketball. We'll also be keeping track of the games that are going to be going on or game that is going on during our live show tonight, so you won't be missing that. And we will be going to you guys throughout the entire show. Hope to see you there. It's the first episode. I'm excited, and I hope you guys are too. That's right, Coast to Coast. First episode tonight at 7 p.m. Except if you're watching this and it's past the day that it came out, then I hope you watch the VOD. Just Coast to Coast. It's a show on CK2K. It's going to be fun. Now, today's episode is about the rookie that we did not draft in this year's 2018 NBA draft, and that is Alonzo Trier. Now, Alonzo Trier was born January 17th, 1996 in Seattle, Washington. Growing up, he was raised by just his mother, Marcy Trier, while sadly, he never got to meet his dad. His entire life was based around basketball. He didn't really do much kid activities as he was primarily focused on playing basketball. Matter of fact, at 13 years old, he was known to be a basketball prodigy and was featured on the cover of the New York Times magazine in 2009. Also, he shot a Powerade commercial alongside Carmelo Anthony when he was in sixth grade. Now, fast forward a little bit. Alonzo moved all over the states leading up to high school, from his hometown of Seattle, Washington, to Dallas, to Tulsa, to eventually play high school basketball in Nevada. But before we get there, we jump to his junior year in high school. For a lot of you who have been in high school or going to be in high school, a lot of you know that there are 4 years of high school. In his third year, his junior year, he had already played for 3 different high schools. In that same junior year, he averaged a strong 25.5 points per game, 4 rebounds per game, 2.8 assists per game, and 2.1 steals to lead Montrose to a 20-5 record and a National Christian School Athletic Association Division I title. He was then named the 2014 Gatorade State Player of the Year and was a first-team Washington Post All-Met. Yeah, a lot of great stuff. Now, normally when you have a great season like this, you tend to stay and try to repeat or try to pad the stats a little bit more going into college. Not Alonzo. In his senior year, he would once again move schools and transferred all the way to Finley Prep in Henderson, Nevada. Yes, on the complete other side of the United States. This time, he averaged 26.6 points per game and 5.4 boards. He was then named to the 2015 USA Today All-USA second team and was invited to play for the Western team in the 2015 McDonald's All-American game, alongside names like Brandon Ingram, who was on his team, and Ben Simmons, who played for the East. Zoe led his team in scoring with 17 points, but he really showed out in the Jordan Brand Classic, shining with 28 points. And it doesn't stop there. He shot an incredible 8-10. 8-10 in that game, where the West ultimately beat the East 118-116. Ultimately, after high school, Zoe was rated 17th overall nationally and was ranked number 2 at the shooting guard position. He committed to Arizona so he could play with Sean Miller, where he'd face 3 years of ups and downs at Arizona. In his freshman year, Trier averaged 14.8 points per game, 3.3 boards, and he was named to the Pac-12 All-Freshman team and also got the Jerry West Award. Sadly, Arizona got beat to Ron Baker and his Wichita State Shockers 55-65, or 65-55, whichever way you prefer it. Now, the following season in 2015-2016, Alonzo Trier tested positive for PED and was suspended for 19 games, leaving him to only play 18 games that season. And in that time, he averaged 17.2 points per game and snagged 5.3 boards. This was also the year that Arizona looked to do some serious damage as they picked up freshmen like Raleigh Alkins and Kobe Simmons and Lauri Markkanen joining this team. Sadly, Arizona made it only to the Sweet 16, ultimately to lose to Xavier in a heartbreaking 71-73 game. This wouldn't be the only time Trier would be faced with suspension. In his junior year at Arizona, he would be faced with another suspension due to PEDs, and throughout his college career, he would ultimately miss 21 games. But Zoe did end up battling against the claims of him testing positive for PEDs, and he actually won both appeals in both instances. And he actually claimed that the positive tests were results of some pain medication that he was prescribed by a doctor following a car accident that he suffered. Regardless of the situation, these cases altogether could possibly hurt his future NBA draft stock, but we'll get to that in the future. Zoe planned to declare for the draft after his sophomore year, but because of missing so many games, he thought it'd be best that he play one more season, which he did. So in his junior year, he went on to average 18.1 points per game, 2.2 assists, and only 3 boards. Now, I know you guys probably noticed in the previous 2 years, it was around 5 rebounds per game, but thanks to some tall freshmen that Arizona picked up, the rebounding went down a little bit. I think you'd understand. Arizona was ranked 4th and lost in the first round of the NCAA tournament to Buffalo in a surprising 89-68 game. After this season, along with the 2B first overall draft pick, DeAndre Ayton, Alonzo Trier declared for the 2018 NBA draft. Now, surprisingly, after his career and being a prodigy and having such a great high school career, and yes, he had his ups and downs with the suspensions, he was ultimately put on a lot of people's mock drafts to either not be drafted or go somewhere late in the second round. And, well, yeah, Zoe went undrafted. But that same night, the Knicks did end up signing him and added him to what was already a strong rookie draft class that the New York Knicks picked up, drafting Kevin Knox 9th overall and drafting Mitchell Robinson in the 2nd round. So with the Knicks picking up Alonzo Trier, he made our summer league team and he got some good minutes. At first, he was playing his natural 2-guard, but you can see the coaches wanted to try to play him at the 1 with his size. Now let's be real, Zoe had a rough start in the summer league where his ball stopping isolation type of basketball at first wasn't particularly enjoyed by most of the Knicks fans. Alonzo Trier, he was just trying too hard.
Nope.
He does that and has nothing to go to. I don't like him in the point.
He's not a point guard.
Nope.
The kid, he takes a billion dribbles before the idea of passing the ball even comes into his head.
Including myself. But as the summer league continued and the coaching staff played him at the point more and more, he slowly began to impress and had some great games. But the greatest game he had overall in the summer league was his 21 points and 10 assists game that he had against the Los Angeles Lakers. His good play in the latter half of the summer league won over those same doubting fans and the coaching staff alike, and he was rewarded with a 2-way contract with the New York Knicks, I being one of those fans that was won over. Now, once training camp began, the buzz around the undrafted guard continued to grow leading up to the Knicks preseason game, and Zoe did not disappoint. Trier dropped a game-high 25 points in a win over Brooklyn off of an 8-for-12 shooting night. 8-for-12 from the field, while also going 8-for-8 from the free throw line. That's insane for a rookie, and the way he was getting the buckets was incredible.
Conversely, Trier is the only Knick with the knack right now.
The excitement around the Knicks rookie class, primarily the undrafted guard from Arizona, is high, and some are already campaigning to see him start at some point this season, while a few doubters would still like to see him go to the G League. But Coach Fizdale has already been on the record to say that he doesn't expect him to be in the G League for very long. Now, for a story that started off so promising, almost turned disastrous, but there's definitely a light at the end of the tunnel for Alonzo Trier, and it looks very promising. The season ultimately begins for us tomorrow, where we play against the Atlanta Hawks. We don't know if he's going to get minutes. We don't know where he's going to be on the roster, but do you ultimately think that he deserves a spot on the New York Knicks, or do you think he should take the time to grow and be a good player for us in the long run? Let me know in the comment section. As always, keep letting me know what players you want to see me talk about in these Knicks stories. This season is officially beginning. I hope you guys enjoy. I cannot wait to see our opening game against the Atlanta Hawks. Much love to you guys. I will see you in the next video, and I hope to see you tonight in the first episode of Coast to Coast. Catch you guys there. Much love. We out of here.